The 2015 U.S. Open at Chambers Bay is now history. So how did it go? Nicole Sanchez reports that Pierce County officials are celebrating a big win.
For the last week, all eyes have been on Chambers Bay. Not only has it been exciting for the 156 golfers who played in the 2015 U.S. Open and the 40,000 fans who came out every day, this championship, this victory, is also a huge win for Pierce County and Chambers Bay.
It's fun to take it from 3 years of planning and being on pieces of paper and maps and to the real life, and to see it in 3D and to see it in actual, actually unfold. And it's just an amazing operation. Even though I've been involved with it for 4 years, it still kind of takes your breath away when you see it all in action.
I think beyond all of our wildest dreams and expectations, when you're doing something like this for the first time and really don't know what to expect, every day is a new experience and new excitement and different emotions.
One of the biggest concerns, transportation. How to get the tens of thousands of fans to and from the course each day. As it turned out, even with a few road closures, transportation got the green light.
Well, everybody was concerned that traffic would be the big headache. We have to move that many people in and out every day for a week. And frankly, the USGA and our public safety staff have worked really hard to staff over 600 traffic posts and personnel working to get all those buses in and to get all those shuttles in and to get people in and out safely and quickly. Most of the comments have been very, very positive.
Everything that we have is positive. We have not heard any negative comments about the transportation and traffic in the neighborhood. So that was great, great news. You know, we tried to tell people that, yeah, that's the way it's going to be. I think that, you know, now that it's here and people saw that that was truly the case, they're very happy.
A big focus for the county, security. A massive operation involving 37 agencies, including the Pierce County Sheriff's Department, the Washington State Patrol, and Homeland Security, all having to make sure they're up to date with technology.
We're in a different era and a different age for security. And even what the USGA would have done 3 or 4 or 5 years ago for security doesn't suffice today. And so the level of sophistication and the detail is for this open is by far and away the most concrete, most detailed security plan they've put in place yet.
And now that the 2015 U.S. Open is over, the county will take a close look at how things went, looking for any lessons learned so Pierce County can be ready for what the future holds at Chambers Bay.
I love having Pierce County be on the national spotlight, and definitely it was all worth it.
I think the thing that we keep thinking about is, can we do this again in another 10 years? And we certainly hope so.
I think it's just gone even beyond my expectations, transportation, security, anything relative to the support system that we provided to the carrying out of this event has been great. The enthusiasm of the fans and the public has been terrific. So it's all good.
The local economic boost from the U.S. Open is estimated at $140 to $150 million. Joining me to talk about the challenges and triumphs of the championship are Pierce County Executive Pat McCarthy and Pierce County Councilmember Connie Ladenburg. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Thanks. Executive McCarthy, how would you describe the U.S. Open?
It was magical, and it exceeded, of course, my expectations, but I think it exceeded all of our expectations. It was a great partnership with the USGA, Kemper Sports, Pierce County, our local communities, the state. I mean, everyone leaned in to make this event and this championship a success, and for all intents and purposes in my book, it totally was. The only thing that we couldn't control was Mother Nature, and she did us well as well.
She was right on the button
great.
On that, wasn't she? Connie, it's your district out there where the Chambers Bay is located and the U.S. Open took place. How would you describe the week?
Well, I will share the word that I heard probably very, very often from everyone out there: totally awesome. Many of my constituents, obviously live in that particular area. And so I've heard from them already how excited they were. But just standing next to people along the ropes or in the bleachers, people would look around, oh my God, this is so awesome, this is so much fun, I'm having a blast. The enthusiasm was amazing, contagious mm-hmm. also, but just amazing. I didn't hear any negatives, except maybe some sore feet from walking a little bit too much.
Now, to pull something like this off took a lot of partners and partnerships, the county and a lot of other agencies. How do you think the county and the and its partners did in running the open?
Well, I think Pat did a great job in her leadership, you know, as a county executive, of building those relationships with obviously University Place, you know, like I said, it's in their backyard, but other jurisdictions around the city of Tacoma, city of Lakewood, city of Steilacoom, goes on and on. And the outreach that we've done in those regards, I think we're really very, very positive. And I'm looking forward to, and I think we're all looking forward to maintaining those kinds of relationships as we have discussions about what our next steps are in regards to that course and that tournament.
What do you think about the partnerships?
You know, I think they're critically important for the USGA feeling welcome to come back. And, of course, we want them back. But I really think the county has proven that they have the desire to have an open here at Chambers Bay from John Ladenburg's, Connie's husband's, original vision back in the 2003, and then moving forward during his tenure, and then me taking the baton forward and the execution. Really, I mean, we didn't plan it that way, let me just tell you, but it worked out really well. And I think now that people have experienced it, prior to having the open here, people just couldn't imagine what it was and what it would be and how we could create that sense of place for Pierce County, for the Pacific Northwest, for the state of Washington as a result of this championship. And that's what happened that I think is one of the great benefits of the open.
Now, in preparation for this, you attended several U.S. Opens over the last few years. How do you think ours compared to what you saw in your research?
Well, I would tell you this. I think the USJ have a phenomenal team. They're consummate professionals. They've been at it for a long time. So if you marry that kind of expertise and that willingness to really engage a local community, because as I like to say, the USJ didn't just swoop into town with their bag of and then get their bag of money and swoop out. They embedded somebody with Danny Sink here in our community. He probably did 200 presentations to every group you can imagine. And I will just tell you, all of that experience of seeing those other opens led us to understand what we needed to do to ensure that we could create a good experience for the fans, for the host community, for University Place, and really for the region. So we learned a lot, took a lot of notes. I took a lot of different people representing different points of view, and I think it's paid off for us. But it's really that relationship that the county has really had with the USGA that's made a difference.
And we are a little bit unique because we're a public course. We're one of three public courses that the Open's been on, you know, over their 115 years that they've been doing this. So working with government is a little bit different for them than going to a private club and working with their board, for example. So I've heard back that they're very pleased with our relationship, and we've made it easy, in a sense, for them. Having Danny Sink here has been phenomenal. He is the consummate Southern gentleman, mm-hmm. and he loves our community. He would love to stay here, but his job takes him other places. But they just love Pierce County as a community, but they love Pierce County as a government, too. So I think they're going to come back.
Yeah.
Now, as we turn our sights backward over what has just happened, what would you do differently? How would you what would you handle a little bit differently than we did?
Well, you know, I think we had in essence somewhat of a trial run because we had the two U.S. amateur in 2010, so we had an experience to kind of see everything from corporate sponsorships, how do you do that, to transportation, to the fan experience. And it was different because in an amateur, the fans get to go along with the golfers, whereas in an open, it's a whole different kind of breed of cat where you're fans are set apart from the actual golfers during the four days of championship. And I think if we could turn back the clock, you know, having more spaces where fans could see a play, but all of the things that were brought up as criticisms, and I'm not an agronomist, I like to say, so even issues relative to the course or the play, all are fixable.
Right.
And so there's nothing that was reported that anyone that I heard said that couldn't be fixed for the future. And so I think the USGA will look at that. They'll do a postmortem. The county's doing a postmortem. We'll come together in a month or two when we've, you know, calculated and looked at all the stats and looked at all the metrics of what happened and what transpired over the course of the weekend, and we'll make some evaluations. But we want them back. I think they want to come back. I think it, for all intents and purposes, it was a fabulous event. I mean, just looking at the pre-championship viewership for the broadcasters was up. The merchandise sales was up. I mean, on every metric you can possibly calculate, it looked like we were beyond what anyone's expectations. So I think we are heavy on the plus side of the ledger at this stage of the game.
We broke all the records too, and it started probably with ticket sales last year. They went on sale during the Open of last year, and the first day of sales, they broke the server, you know, because there was such a demand. We broke the record for signing up volunteers in 36 hours. 5,000, actually 6,000 volunteers in 36 hours. Corporate sales, mm-hmm. you know, broke the record for corporate sales. And it just, the list just goes on and on. You know, I don't know what we could have done different to make any of that better. I mean, we were already the best. As Pat said, the fan experience, there were some complaints about it, but there were a lot of people that adjusted. It's different. Mm-hmm. The USGA said it would be different from a very long time ago. Mm-hmm. They tried to warn people, or at least prepare people, that it's almost like target golf. It was target spectators. You had to go to certain areas to be able to see. They built more bleachers for this tournament than they've ever had before. Mm-hmm. The largest bleachers that they've ever had, 6,000 people on the 18th hole, which is huge.
Huge, yeah.
And then one of their sponsors' tents, their building, it was a two-story building, first time they've ever done that for their, you know, our corporate sponsors. So there was a lot of firsts for this tournament. But as Pat said, you know, any concerns or problems that were there are easy to fix, and it'll get done. You know,
and
we learned from that.
The USGA is planning. They will survey the fans. They will mm-hmm. survey the players. They will survey attendees. They will survey the corporate sponsors. They'll survey and take all that information and get that feedback. We'll take that feedback in, and we'll see, make adjustments so that it is even better next time.
How do you feel our chances are for getting the U.S. Open back?
Great.
100%.
Yeah. Good.
Yeah.
Good.
Unequivocal.
That's right.
Thank you for being with us today and talking about the Open and giving us your insights. You can watch our program again and share it with friends anytime you'd like on our website, piercecountytv.org, or on our mobile app for smartphones and tablets. I'm Dave Hinman. Thanks for watching.